Good morning, everyone. And we want to welcome all of you with us today. I know we have visitors. Their kids are a part of our program today, their parents, grandparents. And it's just a wonderful power and spirit that we want to engage in our lives. Our world has been affected by negativity. Our world has been affected by dishonoring voices that's stealing away our heritage and our beginnings and wanting to change another spirit on this land that doesn't include God, which really has made our country what it is. So this whole thing is to engage and stir up within each of us the power of honor in our lives. This is Veterans Day, and we're going to direct our honor towards the veterans that has preserved our nation for many, many, many generations, but the ones that are still here today, we especially want to honor you. So the whole program is set up for that. So we're just going to open up in prayer, begin our format, and it's different than our regular church service, but I tell you, it's a very important thing. So let's pray together. God, today we just come before you as we honor the lives and the service men and women that have placed themselves many in harm's way to preserve what started hundreds of years ago. So God, today we want to release an honor voice. We want to release that anointing and appreciation that comes to those that deserve it. So we set it before you and ask that you live in our time. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you this morning.
Please be seated.
Praise the Lord. Let's give the kids a big hand clap as they walk down. Appreciation to that. Amen. Amen. We just have some announcements for our church and let you know of some things that's coming up in our near future. So this is my wife, Linda, if you don't know that. We are in our second phase of marriage. Thursday was our 49th year of marriage together. We're not really looking for applause, but we want you to know we're committed. So.
Yes, we are committed. I just love watching you all come in this morning, and to see many of you who are veterans creates honor in me, as well as just love for you. And just loving our kids, being able to honor you this morning, just keeps that in our generation from generation to generation. And we are so blessed that you are all here with us. We just have a couple announcements today. Our Spokane Christian Academy is having a school auction. That's on November 22nd, and the tickets are available today. You can purchase them for $20. And if you just want to give a donation today, that'd be great too. Our school is a blessing, and God is honoring it.
You know, one thing that we are focusing on is putting something in our kids that's our sphere of responsibility that the public school system do not. They don't focus on the things that we do, that we had, or that I had when I was growing up. We did things like this in honor points, but our in general, our public schools don't do these things today. But I think it's important to make and keep our country great. Just some of the items that we have for auction. There's an iPad. There's a lot of things that really help your family and things. One of the items is that there is a helicopter ride for two. So you bid on that as well, which I'm thinking about that pretty heavy myself. And there's Sharp Shooting Membership, which is an establishment, indoor shooting. So you can bid on that as well. We have tickets for Mariners, which next year they're going to be champions. So those are the ones you really want. And then there's a Gonzaga men's basketball that has been signed and that you can bid on, and also tickets for that. So there's a lot of good items, and most importantly, all of the funds go to be able to have a school like we have and train our kids up in the way that they should go. So it's not just a taking for us. It goes directly to that, to train up our new generation. Amen.
We have one more announcement we want to tell you all, is that we know that Thanksgiving is coming up, and Thanksgiving comes and goes and it jumps into Christmas, but we just want to take a special evening, Wednesday evening, November 27th, and we just want to worship God. We want to say thank you for a great day. Thanksgiving, what it's all about is to be thankful. So if you want to come and join us at 7 o'clock that Wednesday evening, we want to share some testimonies about what God has done in your life and just be thankful.
And you know, that's another thing that's been pulled out of our system is a thankful heart. And this is a service to help keep that alive and keep it working. Church and church life is really important in the health of our country. How many know that darkness wants that to be quieted so a new agenda can be brought forth? And we have good things on purpose. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Near you is an offering envelope. We encourage you to give. All of these things that we do take effort. They reach in people. We have a food program. We have kids program and young people things. So be a cheerful giver. Give into those things that have an investment in our nation. We're going to have some worship. We encourage you to enter in with that. And then after that, we're going to dismiss kindergarten and preschool kids. And we have a nursery area open if it applies to you. So let's stand up, and we're going to worship God. We're not singing to you. We're not singing to each other, but we're just coming before God and singing unto Him. Join with us if you can.
Spokane Christian Academy is honored to share the opportunity for you to honor some very special people in our nation. We hope that you learn a little bit and that you're prompted to extend your gratitude to the men and women that have served our country well. For many, Veterans Day is just a day off from school or work. But there is a rich history that adds great meaning to the day. Our middle school students are eager to share that information with you.
We celebrate Veterans Day every year, but how many of us actually know where the holiday came from? Most people know that Veterans Day is a day to honor Americans who have sacrificed their lives for our country. But there's more to the story than you may have realized.
To help you celebrate this holiday more deeply, here are some things you may not already know about Veterans Day. World War I, known at the time as the Great War, officially ended when the Treaty of Versailles was signed on June 28, 1919, in the Palace of Versailles outside the town of Versailles, France.
However, fighting ceased 7 months earlier when an armistice when an armistice or a temporary cessation of hostilities between the Allied nations and Germany went into effect on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month. In 1919, President Woodrow Wilson proclaimed November 11th as the first commemoration of Armistice Day with the following words.
To us in America, the reflections of Armistice Day will be filled with solemn pride and the heroism of those who die in the country's service, with gratitude for the victory, both because of the thing from which it has freed us and because of the opportunity it has given America to show our sympathy with peace and justice in the councils of the nations.
By 1954, our country survived two more major wars, World War II and Korean War. American effort during World War II, 1941 through 1945, saw the greatest mobilization of the U.S. Army, Navy, Marines, and Air Force in the nation's history. More than 16 million people, some 5.7 million more, served in the Korean War, 1950 to 1953.
At the urging of the service organization, the 83rd Congress decided to reinstate Armistice Day as Veterans Day to honor the veterans of all wars. President Eisenhower signed the legislation on June 1, 1954.
Veterans Day hasn't always been celebrated on November 11th. 1968, the Uniforms Holiday Bill assigned the fourth Monday of October as Veterans Day, despite the disapproval of many states who chose to celebrate Veterans Day on its original day.
President Gerald R. Ford recognized the significance of the actual date of Veterans Day carried historic and patriotic value to Americans and veterans who deserve to be honored. So in 1978, he signed a new law returning Veterans Day home to November 11th. This action supported the desires of the overwhelming majority of state legislatures, all major veterans, service organizations, and the American people.
By holding true to the date, Americans are able to focus on the importance of Veterans Day, which is to honor and celebrate veterans for their patriotism, passion for our country, and selflessness in serving for the common good.
Thank you, Toupe. I wanted to just take a few moments, as it is our Sunday service, but talk about on the same theme that our presentation is, and it's titled Honoring. It is something that is a very powerful part of life. It's unique to our country, as it was in that presentation by President Reagan, the Soldier's Pledge. This guy wrote down some virtues, character, integrities that he vowed to perform and to give away, cost him his life, but it wasn't just an empty gesture. It was a cost that has affected us today, because that message wasn't just from him, it was also in a lot of other people. It would cause them to lay their life down that way. It is a virtue, it's a characteristic to live an honorable life. Can you say amen to that? I believe that in our land, I think, you know, believing believers, they feel some things, that our nation is in a real conflict right now. And it's not a conflict between Democrat, Republican, between this race and that race. It's a conflict between good and evil. It's a conflict in spirit between heaven and God's purpose for mankind and the devil's purpose for mankind. And if that conflict is an easy battle, if we fight it with the weapons that God has given us and not the warfare weapons that man uses, flesh against flesh, carnality against carnality, anger against anger, convictions against convictions. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but we have to know them and to exercise them. One of the greatest points that we have and purposes of our assignment as a church is to put these things in young people that has been extrapolated out of so many young people in our country and our nation today. They to lay their life down for something isn't just a will of a man. It's an unction from the Lord that connects with the will of man. In the scripture that in Romans 13 and 7, and it reads in there, give or render honor to whom honor is due. Honor is a force. It's a powerful force. And what it does is it lifts and it strengthens when you honor somebody. Honor builds, it edifies, it reinforces. Honor is something that you give away freely. It's not forced upon you. But if you don't know what that is, you can't give it away. The phrase and the term is, you can't give away what you don't have. And honor is something you stir up. It's something that's provoked on the inside of you by peers. It's provoked on the inside of you by leadership and influences in your life. Your parents. We have a generation now that raises kids, in general, overall, that they don't know how to train their kids in honor because they've never been trained in honor. Many of them are raised in influences by people that came back from Vietnam that were dishonored when they came, and they were broken. They were messed up. And the only way we are going to win people to release honor is to know how to put it inside of them. For that to happen, people of honor have to be able to give it. I remember that year when the Vietnam War was over. It was the early 70s. I was just out of high school. And when it came back, it was all over the news. It was in all the print. And it was an ugly scene. Soldiers coming back, and they were spat upon. They were ridiculed. They were defamed. And it affected. It was in a war zone. And it was in war is a hard place. I think when you go over there with the life of God on the inside of you, you face war differently than when you go over there just as a citizen. I think it's important that you know the reasons that you do some things like that. And when you come back and you didn't have that and people degraded and demoralized you, it wounded those people. They say right now that the rate of suicides among veterans is the highest point that they've had maybe ever. I think that's because we don't know how to honor. It is at least an influence in that part. You have the power within you to give honor. It's there, but you have to grow it. You have to develop it, and you have to give it away. It is really important. I remember growing up, we would have at the end of the school year, we would have like a game day. It would be like a celebration day. Everybody graduated, or at least most of us did. So we would graduate, and we would have field events. We'd have races and competitions, and they would give you a ribbon. And that ribbon was a point of honoring unto you for a fee. When you graduated from your class, often they gave you a diploma, a certificate. I've accomplished something. It's a gesture of honor. It's important that we have them. You have the power to give honor. When you do, you lift somebody up. When you congratulate them, when you say, job well done, when they come out, they have a ceremony, a celebration time that says, attaboy. We need some attaboys in our lives. Can you say amen to that? We need encouragement in our life, not phony. There's a proverb that says that giving honor to a fool will bring disgrace. You know, you don't honor non-accomplishment. You honor, though, people that did something. That's what our day is about. I remember growing up, I grew up in a rural community, small community. In that community, there was a man that got a dishonorable discharge. So you got to know, though, that's like
It's two centuries ago. Not really. That was supposed to be funny. There's more humor. You can laugh at me. But anyway, it was a true event that a young man was dishonorably discharged. And you know, the whole community gasped. You could almost hear it. Because of the atmosphere that it was brought. Because why? There was so much promotion for honor in our culture. We used to have Veterans Day parade in a little small community. And it was like six vehicles in it. But we honored that, and it brought honor to the system. Now there's so much device to tear honor down in leaders and in virtuous things. The only place that honor is going to be promoted is primarily through you, the people that know God. We have to do this. We cannot be silent when it comes to the force of honor in our community. Proverbs 3 and 9 says this, honor the Lord with. Now it goes on and tells you what that is, but we're just going to talk about those for 2 minutes. Honor the Lord with something. Today, this is an honor to the veterans. We have veterans that are here today. I'm not sure if there's anybody from World War II. I mean, that age group is really at the horizon or the sun setting. And it's important to honor that generation. But what's also important to honor the Vietnam, the Korean people, and those people that had service unto us. Giving honor to whom honor is due. Honor is an action. There's something behind it. Honor the Lord with. Honor your father and mother. There's a verse that says, honor your wife as a weaker vessel. You know, not a lot talks about that. Of bringing honor into your life. Bringing honor to other people's lives. It's an important factor. Words reward. There's diplomas and there's acknowledgments. There's economic. You get bonuses for a job well done. Honor is a release. And I'm telling you, it does something in somebody's life when honor is given and it's received. Soldiers, when they come back, you know, it used to be that they had parades and that they had, you know, the ticker tape, you know, in New York, and they had the big events when they came back from war. Now, when soldiers come back from conflict or things, their leaders say, don't wear your uniform. Because of people that are looking to decry that, to put it down. I think that has been stolen from us. I think we have to be forceful to take it back. One of the reasons we have this day every year. 2 Timothy 2 and 20 says this, in a great house there's vessels of honor and dishonor. But if a man purge, a woman purge themselves, they will be a vessel of honor. Let me just provoke you today. Develop and grow more of an honoring attitude in your life. Know how to say thank you for your service. You know, we honor today the veterans, but I'm telling you, the law enforcement, they put their lives on the line. There's more conflict against them. And you say, well, what if they're bad? What if they're not? Don't you let your possibilities for a negative in your life steal away your position to be an honor-giving person. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise. I'm telling you, when you honor, it doesn't just do something to the receiver. Honor does something to the giver. You have to be provoked to that, to say please and thank you. That's a training on the inside of you. It's called courtesy. It's called integrity. It's called virtue. You need to have the virtue of giving honor instilled and provoked in your lives. Today, we're giving honor to people. We're giving honor to people that have laid down their lives. Some more seriously, but it's all the same. When you're protecting our nation, and I just encourage you, each of you, you young people, develop the force of honor. Don't let this world steal that virtue away from us. Can you say amen, church?
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. We're going to continue on.
We have 40 very special guests with us today.
and we're going to honor them. As I read your name, those veterans that are with us today, will you please stand so we can recognize you? And the hardest part is let's hold our applause until we have all 40 standing. We also have some of our children have prepared a small card that tells you thank you. So they're going to be coming around to you and getting that to you. So let's start with the U.S. Army, with David Bartholomew, Kathy Eisenhuth, Michael Ferency, Jerry Flick, Larry Hampton, Tim Hill, which I think he's up in the video booth, Greg Hoskinson, Daniel Klein, John Lindstrom, George Lund, also in our video booth, Jim McKinney, Ryan Quirk, John Snell, Charles Zagsma, better known as Chuck. And now from our Marine Corps, and Marine Corps gentlemen, happy birthday today. It is the Marine Corps birthday. Hoorah. Okay. Matthew Gady. Paul Roberts. Tyler Roberts. Jeffrey Wright. From the U.S. Navy, Jim Allen. Jim Fickle. Robert Hertz, Will Manuel, Jim Rickerson, Ivan Roberts, Philip Roberts, Patty Schaffels, and Jim Singlinger. From the U.S. Air Force, and I'm going to apologize, we may have a name wrong here, Lonnie Bank, Todd Beamster, Paul Bowler. Hey, Brady, turn around for me. Turn around. We have a gentleman with his hand up. There you go. Okay. Gilbert Cervantes, David Eisenhuth, Tom Haney, Mrs. Sally January, Barry January, Jack Laszlo. And I'm sorry, I think I went right on into the Air Force, so my apologies. Clyde McGill, Carrie Mitchell, and Steve Passamonte. Can we please give our veterans a round of applause? You may be seated. In addition to these ladies and gentlemen that are here today, we have a whole wall of people out there that our students and our staff would like to recognize. Some of them simply could not be here physically today. Some of them have already passed on. But we have a number of families that want to honor those that have served, not just currently, but have served in the past. Check those walls out. You're going to see some of the same family names over and over and over again, because it is a family heritage, and it's just a wonderful thing. Pastor?
We want to do something that is we've not done before. I like original things. How about you? There is something that has been set up by wonderful people. They set up a honor flight. How many's heard of Honor Flight? Where they take veterans to D.C. and to visit their appropriate memorial. I just think it's a marvelous and wonderful idea. Different airlines I know are participating in this, and they run everything at a bare bones, and they put up things with hotels and eating establishments and things. And it's just part of this honor. And we want to take up an offering to honor the veterans. Doesn't that sound like a great idea? So we're going to do that right now, and you can. There's near you offering envelope, and you can do that because we're doing it through the church with a tax donation receipt. But you know what? I'd do it if it wasn't a tax donation. How about you? Because it's got an honoring mechanism, and this is how we do that. We gesture honor through different means and different ways. And one way is an honor like this, where they go back and they visit. And that's flight, and that's eating, and that's where they can stay as well. So I just encourage you, if you wanted a receipt for that, you can get that. But don't do it because you get a tax receipt. Get it because you're releasing your honor into lives. All of this, everything of this, will go to the honor flight mechanism so that we can just do that. If you want, we'll tell you how much we receive, because we want this to be a success. Amen? So God, today as we take this and receive this offering, it is an honor to give honor to whom honor's due. But God, we just choose to believe it's going to be big. It's going to help. It's going to bless. We thank you for that. Helping us in Jesus' name. Amen. It's $950 for each one. If you want to do one yourself, hey, let's knock it out of the park. Amen. Praise the Lord. All right.
Thank you.
coming.
The story of taps. The 24th note melancholy bugle call known as taps is thought to be a revision of a French bugle call signaled tattoo that notified soldiers to cease an evening's drinking and return to their garrisons.
It was sounded an hour before the final bugle call to end the day by extinguishing fires and lights. The last five measures of tattoo resemble taps.
Our present-day taps came from the American Civil War in 1862, when Union General Daniel Adams Butterfield hummed a version of it to an aide who wrote it down in music.
Butterfield then asked the brigade bugler, Oliver W. Norton, to play the notes, and after listening, lengthened and shortened them while keeping the original melody.
He ordered Norton to play this new call at the end of each day thereafter instead of the regulation call. This music was heard and appreciated by other brigades who then asked for copies and adopted the bugle call.
It was even adopted by Confederate buglers. This music was made the official Army bugle call after the war, but not given the name Taps until 1874.
The first time taps was played was at a military funeral and may also have been in Virginia soon after Butterfield composed it. Union Captain John Tidball, head of an artillery battery, ordered it played for a burial of a cannoneer killed in action.
Not wanting to reveal the battery's position in the woods to the enemy nearby, Tidball substituted taps for the traditional three rifle volleys fired over the grave.
Taps was played at the funeral of Confederate General Stonewall Jackson 10 months after it was composed. Army infantry regulations by 1891 required taps to be played at military funeral ceremonies.
Taps now is played by the military at burial and memorial services to accompany the lowering of the flag and to signal the lights out command at day's end.
Thank you.
We have a future, a hope and a future for Keep God in the Middle of It. Amen. We're so glad that you got to come today. Out in the blue wall, outside the back two doors, is things that we have up and coming. We'd like for you to look at that. If you're looking for a church home, we want to welcome you here. Also, there's information about the honor flights. You can pick those things up. And visit one another, greet one another, make sure everybody knows the love of God is in you and in this place. God, today we just pray for our nation again. And just what the song said, bless our nation. Help us, God, beyond our own cognizance, beyond our own thoughts. We ask that you protect our soldiers, protect our people in the front line right today. We pray, Father, for law enforcement. We pray for the first responders. God, the people that serve and give their lives for this nation. And God, right now we just come up against that spirit of opposition. Expose it for the foe and the enemy to your plan that it really is. May we be aware of it. May we be a people that know how to release honor and your strength in this land. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen. God bless you. Thank you for coming.